Hello students, myself Professor Ankur. I welcome everyone for the GATE sum session on analog circuits. Today we are going to solve important sum on topic of power amplifier. So let's start with our second session on power amplifier. So let's take the first question. This is from the GATE 2014 EC paper. And the question is, for 2N338 transistor, the manufacturer specifies Pmax equal to 100 milliwatt at 25 degree Celsius free air temperature, and the maximum junction temperature TJ max is equal to 125 degree Celsius. Its thermal resistance is. So first of all, this question is from the topic of heat sink of power amplifier, where if we are aware of the power dissipated by the device, then we can calculate the thermal resistance and vice versa. So the relation for power dissipation is TJ max minus TA by theta, where TJ max is the junction temperature, TA is the ambient, or you can say air temperature, theta is basically defined as thermal resistance. So the value of PD is equal to 100 milliwatt, TJ max is 125 degree Celsius, TA is 25 degree Celsius. So when we talk about calculation for theta, we will get on substitution theta as 1000 degree Celsius per watt. So this is the answer. The thermal resistance of the transistor is 1000 degree Celsius per watt. This is from the GATE 1998 ECE paper. Let's have a look at the question. A distorted sinusoid has amplitudes A1, A2, A3 of the fundamental second harmonic, third harmonic respectively. The total harmonic distortion is option A, option B, option C, and option D. So first of all, we need to understand here that harmonic distortion can be explained as a distortion or corruption in the output waveform due to the generation of harmonics. So if V1 is the amplitude of the fundamental frequency, V2, V3, V4, dot 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 Vn are the amplitudes of the higher order harmonics, then the total harmonic distortion can be expressed as under root of V2 square plus V3 square plus V4 square dot 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 Vn square, divided by under root of V1 square. So it is as good as under root of V2 square plus V3 square plus V4 square dot 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 Vn square, divided by value of V1. So now when you look at the question, the terminology of V is getting replaced by the parameter A. So A is the amplitude and V is the amplitude here. So ethically, if you try to match the relation, the option is option B. So the correct answer for this question is option P. So this is from the GATE 1995 EC paper. Let's have a look at the question. And the question is, the circuit shown, the figure supplies power to on 8 volt speaker. The values of IC and VCE for the circuit will be. So there is a circuit here and there are two transistors shown, Q1 and Q2. There's a current source for Q1 transistor, and Q2 transistor is having collector current defined as IC. The voltage between collector and emitter is defined as VCE. The base of the first transistor is grounded, and the base of the first is connected to emitter. The emitter of the second is connected to, the base of the second is actually connected to the emitter of the first transistor. And at the emitter of the second transistor, we are having a 8 ohm that is being connected at the lower potential of minus 15. So the lower point is not ground, actually it is connected to minus 15 supply. And across the 8 ohm, we are having a loudspeaker of impedance 8 ohm. So first of all, what we need to understand here is, for transistor Q1, the value of VEB is 0.7. with VB value, the base potential going to ground. So the value of VE, which is now VE1, is 0.7 volts. Whatever is the voltage of emitter 1 is directly given to the base of the second transistor. So VE1 is going to be equal to VB2. So VB2 will now become 0.7 volt. VE2, which is VBE minus VE, because VBE can be defined as VB minus VE. So automatically you will get VB2 value being 0.7 and also VB2 value being 0.7. The value of VE2 will now become 0 volt. So it's as good as the emitter of the second transistor is at zero potential. So now if I want to find the VCE, the value of VCE will become VC minus VE, where VC is 15 and VE is 0. So automatically VCE will come as 15 volt. So we got the first voltage parameter as 15. Since the value of emitter potential is 0, I can find IC is equal to IE as potential difference upon resistance. So it will be 15 minus 0 by 8. The value will come as 1.875 ampere. This will be the value of IC, or you can say IE. So as per the requirement of the question, we were supposed to find the value of IC and VCE. So the value of IC, which is actually IC2, the value is 1.875 ampere. And the value of VCE is basically the value of VCE2 that will be becoming as 15 volt. So the answer is 1.875 ampere, 15 volt. This is the answer for the question.